I know this looks like I'm starting another mailbag, but I'm not. That's not what this is today. Mostly because this is no surprise I know what it is, because they said so on it. It is a multimeter. They say it's $1.34. They're lying. But it is cheap. Let's show you what it is. Digital multimeter. The only reason I know that it's cheap is because I ordered a cheap one. This is, in fact, the cheapest multimeter on Banggood. Didn't really need another multimeter, because I have a couple of cheap ones here already, and I have some more expensive ones that I can borrow from work anytime I want to. But I kind of wanted to see what the cheapest meter on Banggood looked like. So, and by cheapest meter on Banggood, $6.62 Canadian, $4.99 American. You can't buy lunch at McDonald's for that. So, what do we have here? In the box, we get one multimeter, one manual, one pair of leads that are somewhat flexible. I'm sure they're not silicone. They're more flexible than some that I've seen. They're not nearly as good as the proper Fluke ones, but you know, for $5, give or take, I didn't really expect anything else. Safety warnings, whatever. Okay, so some specs here. So we have 3.5 digits, 1999 count, half inch high, polarity automatic, indicated minus, good. Measurement method, double integral, and all digital switch implement. Okay. Whatever. I'm going to pause and throw back. Actually, no. Let's take a peek. So for voltage, 200 milliamp, 2000 milliamp, 20, or millivolts, sorry. 2000, 20, 200, and 1000. AC volts, 750 and 200. DC amps from 2000 microamps. 2000, yeah, micro, 20 milliamp, 200 milliamp, 10 amp. HFE, which is transistor measurement. Square wave measurement. Frequency, I guess. Diode and continuity beep. Impedance from 200 ohm range, 2000, 20K, 200K, 2000K. We have a transistor tester, but you have to know what it is and what the pinout is before you put it in there, which is definitely a downside compared to these things, where you can just put them in any random way and it will figure it out and tell you what's going on. Oh! I was looking for a 9-volt battery. Okay, is that everything? And then we have the voltmillion, milliamps, and a common, and a 10-amp max for... Oh! We have AC amps, or DC amps, we don't have AC amps. Okay. Well, so what I'm going to do, let's put the battery in it next. What does that want? I'm going to assume Phillips. So I'll grab small Phillips bit for me multi-driver. Not captive screws. That could cause you issues at some point. Okay, what do we got in here? So, 9-volt battery holding. Let's go back in again. Focus, thank you. So, let's not poke with the metal thing anymore. So, 9-volt battery holder. There's the back of the transistor. or tester holder. Fuse, just a not one of the high-end sand filled or ceramic ones. It's just a normal little fuse. So if you overamp it, it's going to pop. If you ridiculously overamp it, it'll pop spectacularly. Your jack inputs, your current shunt, the blob that does 99.99% of everything. What is that little chip there? You said getting his magnifying glass out. LM358. Completely standard op amp. Big 104J capacitor. So there's not much really to see the other side. I'm not going to take it apart. The other side's just going to be a multi wiper switch on the back. My point in coming in here really though is to get some power on it. And put it back together. Okay, does it light up? It does. Well, that's cool. Tells you when you're on a high voltage range. Very positive detents. Okay. Yeah. Really? That all? That's as far in as those go. Icky, icky. Okay. Let's go down into the lowest impedance range. What am I going to prop that up on? Soldering sponge. Will that hold it so you can see it? Yeah. So now then. Okay. Once I've got a good contact here, 0.4 ohms. That's not bad for a dead short into there. Then how am I going to put this thing through its paces? I know. I'll compare it against a bunch of other meters. Stand by. Okay, so here's the field for the test. The brand new cheapy Fluke 23 that I've been carrying around in my tool case for over 20 years at work. Fluke 289 from work, which is probably the most expensive meter here by a long shot. That's also borrowed from work. Over here, the Fluke 375, also borrowed from work. It's only a few years old. This guy's only a few years old. The Radio Shack digital multimeter that I have had since I was a teenager. And the Hielke card tester, which is my normal go-to just because it's so darn convenient. So, and for now, we'll test the DC voltage. We'll just use my auto DC to DC converter and we'll see what we get. So that guy says 12.02. Eleven point nine nine volts there. I'm gonna guess that this Radio Shack meter is the worst in the lot. 12.14, 12.10, 09, 5, 3. Okay. Oh, still dropping. Right. Maybe that's because of the battery. I don't know. What haven't I checked yet? This Fluke over here. 12.1. So this guy agrees pretty favorably with all of them. Okay, AC volts. Don't try this at home. 119.8. Really? Okay. 120 exactly. Okay. So, let's see what our test victim, our actual test victim, is saying here. That's not bad. My other good meter. I'm not going to do that with this little guy because his probes are too short to get into the plug, and I just don't want to be much more dangerous than I already am being back there. 119.4. That's right in the range. That's excellent. Okay, I'm going to try something different now. Just pause for a second. Okay, so let's try a resistance here. This is a 10 ohm 1% power resistor. So it being a 1% resistor, we should actually get fairly close to that, shouldn't we? So first of all, our test victim. Okay. Next, the card meter. It takes its time. 11.7. This guy was 12.02, he said. Oh, okay, well, let's try that Radio Shack that I hate so much. Yeah. Yeah, that's useless. Okay, we'll try, where are we next? The Fluke 375. Let's actually put it on impedance here. 11.1, and it's making a beepy noise. 11.2. Okay. 11.4. And 12.6. You know what? Okay. That's pretty good.
I'm going to get
a higher impedance resistor. I'm still going to use a power resistor just because they're easy to see. Okay, now let's try this with a high resistance. That's the only one that's not auto-ranging. This one's battery died, so I'm just going to pretend it doesn't exist. Plus, we know it's the least accurate one of the bunch. So, we'll start back there this time. This resistor says 50K on it. 52.5. Okay, 52.9. Those guys agree pretty closely. 52.69. 52.8. And now, the reason we're here, 52.6. That's quite reasonable. Hey, what else have I got to test it with? How about diode test? 5.8, 5.79 forward. and nothing reverse. Yeah, that's good. 4.78 forward. Really high reverse. 0.52 volts forward. Open circuit in reverse. This guy now, it shares diode and capacitor mode. So I just gotta set it to diode mode. It's auto-ranging, but it's got so many different functions on it. And I like it for that, but it doesn't seem to be... These other meters are agreeing with each other more than they're agreeing with that one. So it's got forward voltage of 0.56 as well. So diode test works fine. This guy doesn't have a capacitance test, so I can't really look at that. So let's try the transistor test thing. HFE, this is a 2222, which is NPN. So a 50-50 chance, I can't remember which way round it goes. That's probably not it. Okay. So transistor test mode, I was doing that correctly, it just doesn't seem to be super happy that way. I think I wasn't really planning on using that for transistor anyway. I was planning on using it for voltage and impedance. This guy is my go-to transistor tester. It's not quite as cheap, but it's still pretty cheap. One more test, I want to try current, which is going to take a reset here. Okay, here's my current measuring setup. I've got 12 volts coming out of here. I've got it, current limit set up through the roof. I've got the 10 ohm resistor in there, in series. And currently I've got it going through the clamp of that guy, where we can see, according to the power supply, it's 0.97 amps. According to this guy, it's 0.8 amps. So let's start putting meters in series. Okay. Now this guy, 0.94. That's pretty damn close. And my old favorite, 23.94. That's impressive. This guy agrees with everyone. That was interesting. This little, you know, $4.99 American, $6.50 Canadian multimeter, the cheapest one on Banggood. Volts, AC, amps, DC, volts, DC, resistance, diode check, all agree very well with these much more expensive meters and with my cheap little card tester that I got from a pawn shop decades ago. Let's not even talk about this guy. This guy is relegated to the dangerous tasks pile. But I am impressed. It's not going to be my daily meter. That's still going to be this one for hobby. And for work, it's still going to be that one. The other ones have their uses. At work, I'm still going to use this when I'm metering high DC currents on the clamp, because that's what it's made for. That's its major purpose. And if I heavy it out anyway, I'll use it for everything else. That guy is just an excellent general purpose meter. And the Fluke 23 is not that expensive in Fluke's range of stuff, really. And it's just an absolutely great blue collar meter. This thing is way overkill for 99% of what most of us are ever gonna do. But it's still a solid meter, and it's got, what, 4 digits of precision? Who needs that? But these two agreed with each other more than they agreed with this one, which I found a little surprising. But this little guy, bang for the buck for just general knocking around hobby work, that's excellent. I guess I should say Banggood didn't pay me for this. I bought this with my own $5. And nobody paid me for this. This is just me looking at something I bought. I will talk to you later. Thanks for watching.